I hope that this isn't all shaken up and it doesn't explode on me. Well, have you tried the whites from Portugal before? Maybe it's about time you did. Learn more in this video. Welcome back to Exotic Wine Travel. I am your host, Matthew Horky. Welcome back to the show where we help you drink adventurously so you can expand your palate and expand your mind. We're going to get into some exciting, we're going to learn a little bit more about Portuguese white wines today. Before we get started, I want to let you know to check out our Patreon page if you like content like this. You can help support this content and get some even behind the scenes look into what we do in our daily lives. But without further ado, let's get into the wine. So Portugal, a country that a lot of people know about, most people associate with the fortified wines of Port or Madeira. But a lot of people don't know there are exciting table wines, still dry wines being made in the country. As much as I love red Portuguese wines, I think the white dry wines are what excite me the most about the country. For the last couple years, I've been going to Portugal every single year. COVID-19 has kind of knocked my schedule off this year. Hopefully I do make it at the end of the year. I love the country. You have to understand that Portugal has a very old history of wine production. It's regularly one of the top 15 wine producing countries in the world. There's close to 250 indigenous grape varieties, and the white grapes are very, very exciting. A couple things that you need to know. For such a small country, Portugal packs a lot of diversity in terms of wine growing conditions. A cool thing also is a lot of the grapes are planted in all the regions of the country, so you can start to see what the real regional differences and the real terroir differences are throughout the country. Some white grapes that you're going to want to look out for that are exciting. You're going to look out for things called Alvarinho, also known as Albarinho in Spain, Arinto, Gouveia, Viocinho, Encruzado, Fernão Pires, also known as Maria Gomes, Bicel, Sertiel. There's some Malvasia there as well, Rabigato. So there's a wealth of unique white wine grapes. The regions you want to look out for, if you want something crisper, high acidity, if you're a fan of Riesling, if you're drinking a lot of shellfish, haute wines, you want to look to Vinho Verdes. Most famous for Alvarinho, but there is Arinto grown there. There's a lot of different types of Viocinho is also grown there. These wines that have really high acid work perfect with shellfish. Another area you want to look to is the Douro. The Douro is known for port wines and big, hefty red table wines. But you know what? I've been getting excited about the white wines there lately. A lot of them are barrel fermented, and they're just rich white wines with a lot of fruit, a lot of structure. The wood gives them some durability, some ageability. I think those wines are exciting. Then the other regions in the north that are exciting, Bajada, where you're going to get Bicel, and also Maria Gomes, Fernão Pires, some piney kind type of wines. But the region I really love is the Douro, known as the Burgundy of Portugal. There's a lot of white and red wine grapes there. I'm most excited about Encruzado. I don't think I've had a bad Encruzado. These wines, when they're aged in wood, can have real elegant Burgundian type characteristics. Another region that all winemakers are crazy about is the region around Lisbon, or the Lisboa region. A lot of winemakers, when I'm in Portugal, say that that is the premium place, the up-and-coming place. We have a wine from Lisboa we're going to actually taste today. You're also going to get some bigger, heavier white wines in the Setúbal, Tejo, Alentejo, the Algarve. Those are the southern regions of the country. Those are hot regions, more known for red wines, but there are some bigger whites being made there. I am a big fan of, in Alentejo, the white wines made of the grapes Entalvaz, real crisp, easy drinking wines, in addition to Rupajo. I know my pronunciations are going to be terrible throughout this video. It's funny, last time I was in Portugal, an employee from Sogrape told me, she said, just think about when you speak Portuguese, think about a Russian guy trying to pronounce Spanish. And I was like, okay. You know, one of the things I really like about Portuguese white wines is I find all of them have this nice mineral kind of backbone. There's plenty of fruit. You know, some wines can be too minerally without fruit. Some wines can be too fruity without more complexities. I think Portugal has a nice balance in between. And we're going to get into some of these here today. The first one we're going to taste is the Vale do Nidio. This is Alvarinho and Viocinho. This is from the producer Miguel Harantes. Now, these two grapes, it's so funny, are actually known more or grown more in Vinho Verde. And this wine is grown in the Douro, although it's not labeled as a Douro. It's labeled as a Vinho Regional Douriense, which kind of a lower classification, but the wines are coming from the Douro. I expect this to be a little bit richer. Let's give this a go here. Very nice nose. You get this liminess, lemon, kind of kefir, lime, mineral. This might have been aged in wood, because I get just a touch of vanilla, but you know what? Portuguese white wines, I always think they're oaked very well. A little bit of seawater characteristics. Exciting. Let's give this a go. Much richer Alvarinho. The Alvarinho you're going to get in Vinho Verde, like this bad boy from Escatano. This is the Alvarinho from up there in Vinho Verde. This is 2019. These types of wines are going to be more steely, high acid things that you want to have with shellfish. This right here is a richer white wine. Almost, it's not as big as a barrel aged or barrel fermented Chardonnay, but it's kind of getting up there. Beautiful wine. Limey, minerally. You know what I also like about the Douro is I get kind of, there's schist slaty soils there. So I get this slaty kind of type of flavor in the Douro whites, which I wouldn't expect since it's a hot region. So that's really exciting. This wine's beautiful. I'm in the 90 plus point type of range for it. I think it's a wonderful wine. Let's move on, shall we? One wine that we tasted already, I think this is definitely worth seeking out. This is the Chao de São Francisco, Chao de Quinta, Encruzada Haute Reserva 2017 from the Dow. Like I said, this wine was extraordinary, very, very Burgundy. You know what I mean? It's elegant, mineral, had this nice lemony acidity, but still plenty of white peach quince-type flavors up front. Mouth-filling, a long kind of a sandy texture. I mean, I had this at about a 91-point type range. I thought this was extraordinary. I also thought this was a wine that was not even close to being ready to drink. This wine, I think, has a big future. Another thing about these that's cool about these white Portuguese wines, or Portuguese wines in general, is they offer tremendous value for money. I think in the country, this is less than 20 euros, maybe even 15 euros for a world-class white. This is under 50. I think all the wines here I have are under 20 euros, so I think that's really cool. Let's move on here. This is a famous producer I haven't tasted before. This is the Quinta do Convento Reserva Branco 2018. Now, this is from what we talked about earlier, the Lisboa region around the capital of Lisbon. You know, I actually haven't I haven't found what this blend actually is. I've been looking. It was sent to me. I can't find it. So I don't know what the grapes are. But I think we'll be able to taste a little bit of what Lisboa brings to the table. I saw a couple possibilities. Could be anything from Arinto to Sassemion in it. Who knows? I do know that it is aged in oak, and it won a gold medal at the Lisboa wine competition recently. So let's give this a go. 2018. Oh, I almost blended and mixed it. Let's give this a little bit of a go here. So first of all, color looks like a Douro. It's not really, really, really dark. Let's give this a sniff. Now the wood comes out here, but the wood, and this is really well done. It might even be barrel fermented. That's kind of what it smells like. Toast, white peach, white pear, cool white fruits type of deal. Maybe sliced white apricot. It smells really good. Let's give this a go. You this is what I really like about this. Really well done. Saltiness. I actually feel like we're on the beach now in Dalmatia. I feel like I'm swimming in the ocean and licking some rocks. Extremely salty. Really well done with the barrel integration. I'm a big fan. Maybe it is Semillon. It does have some Semillon characteristics. A little of those natural gas type flavors. Really good wine. This is not ready to be drunk yet. I'll have to taste it through a little bit more before I get my final score. But I think I'm pretty close in the 89, 90 point type range. I think this is a really, really nice wine. Shows a great example of why Portuguese wines take oak so well. Wonderful. I think I'm getting a little bit more excited about the Douro Encruzado Reserva and maybe even the Valle do Nidia, but still really, really nice wine. So we don't have a dud yet. Let's move on. Now, I'm cheating a little bit because this is a white wine, but it is actually made from red grapes. This is from Bajada, region known for big tannic reds made out of the Baga grape, but also an area that's traditionally been a sparkling wine area. Sparkling wine production goes back to 1890 there. This is the Rama y Celas, Método Clásico, Blanc de Noirs, Brut, 2017. Let me see if there's any information. 12 months on the lees, 12 months in the bottle. So let's give this a go. I hope that this isn't all shaken up and it doesn't explode on me. Well, I'm glad that nobody was up top there because my face wasn't there because that could have definitely hurt somebody. All right, let's give this a go, shall we? So, I've had some nice sparklings from Portugal lately. I was actually in a champagne blind tasting in November in Hungary, and actually one of the wines I picked was one of my favorites. It was a sparkling wine from the Douro. And it tastes like champagne. Let's give this a go. That shirt scared the crap out of me. I don't know where the cork went. Let's give this a go here. Really nice note. Strawberry. Kind of like an unripe type of strawberry cream. Lemon. You know, it's not. It smells pleasant. Doesn't smell like champagne. It's not overly aromatic. It just smells nice. Delicate. Let's give this a go. Nice mouthfeel, good fine bubbles. I think this is a good sparkling wine. It doesn't have super rich complexities or anything like you want out of champagne, but it's just nice, delicious, serviceable. I don't get the Baga-ness out of it, but I do think it's solid. I'm kind of in the 87, 88 point type range. I think it's a good sparkling wine, just not something that's blowing my face off. Yeah, it's about that. It's good, not overly exciting, but delicious. So, before we go, I want to thank the family wine group in Portugal. They kind of represent these wines, help them go abroad. So they were nice enough to send me some of these wines. Really, check out the white wines from Portugal. They're super exciting. There's a lot of interesting stuff going on. I hope to be back this year. I still actually haven't been to Madeira. I want to go to the island of Madeira. I haven't been to the island of Azores, an island of the wines that I like very, very much. So check it out. So let me know. Are you drinking Portuguese white wines? Do you have any favorites? Let me know in the comments below. Guys, if you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Exotic Wine Travel, and I will see you at the next episode.
Hello, thanks for watching.
Hey, you made it to the end. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, click the bell so you know when new videos are out. If you like content like this, check out our Patreon page where you get some behind-the-scenes exclusive content. Thanks for watching. Cheers.
Cheers.